chosen the most expensive car Mercedes-Benz had to offer in 1983, and that's the 500 SEC.
Mercedes of this generation, I reckon probably one of the finest cars ever made in the world.
And we've set out to pay tribute to this once independent tuner, AMG.
Now, Mike has decided to send us on a mission to convert our dentist car into a full-on wide-bodied AMG tribute car. Now, I'm well up for that idea, but Mike also has complained about the fact the engine didn't really run right, so I've taken it out, taken it apart, and had a really good look inside. Now, first up, I can actually see the barrels and pistons are all in really good nick. There's no scoring, there's no damage anywhere, so that's all fantastic. The rest of the engine also seems to be in pretty good nick too. Now, the heads, on the other hand, there are a few tiny issues. First of all, you can see there's a lot of carbon deposits all over the valves. Also, some of the spark plugs were actually quite oiled up as well. And there seemed to be air leaking past the fuel injection seals. Now, all of those problems can cause the engine to run incorrectly. But actually, it's all kind of irrelevant, because when you think about it, to do a proper AMG tribute car, we need to improve the performance of the engine by actually putting on proper, genuine AMG heads. Now, I've sent Mike off to try and find some original AMG heads with the camshafts, and that's no easy task. But the thing is, if we're going to increase the performance of the engine, we also need to think about increasing the performance of the handling. So I've also been doing some suspension work. If we just compare the old parts with the AMG upgrades, it's actually quite clear to see some of the differences. First of all, you can see that the new spring is about an inch and a half shorter than the old one. It's also slightly thicker in diameter. Of course, that makes the spring stiffer, helps compensate for the lack of coils, but also it means that the car is just going to sit on the road much more nicely. It's going to lower the center of gravity, going to lower the roll centers, and of course, the car's going to look better as well. Now, that's coupled with a custom-designed shock, which has been specially tuned to work with that spring and, of course, the way the dynamics of the suspension are supposed to work. Now, moving on to the brakes, you can see this is our standard 500 SEC brake disc. It's vented, which means it's already going to have quite a good bit of stopping power going on. But if we now compare it to our new one, you can see the new one is actually slightly bigger in diameter. It actually comes from a 560 SEC. And of course, that extra bit of diameter gives you a little bit more leverage, which makes it slightly easier to stop the car. But better than that, if you look at the calipers, you can see this caliper has got a single pot. That's the original caliper. But the new one has got twin pots. So it's actually got two slave cylinders either side. And because you have more surface area, you have more mechanical advantage. And you couple that with the extra diameter of the new disc, then, of course, you've got much better stopping power. And that's really going to help to slow down all those extra horses we're going to get from the engine. Right, so we're now down to the upright, the stub axle on there, and you can see that both the bottom ball joint and the top ball joint do need to be replaced because they are both quite perished. But then, once all this is done, we'll have the beginnings or the foundations of a great little suspension setup. To ensure we take full advantage of our suspension and brake upgrades, it's essential we replace all the tired rubber bushes that make up our coupe's foundation. Early AMG parts are near impossible to source, so here we found a modern equivalent. The suspension and brakes set us back $1,186. Now, my work isn't going to stop here, because I still have some work to do on the back end of the car, but you can really see already that it's going to make a big difference. But actually, it's going to be how these modifications feel on the road that's going to be the real difference. With the ride sorted, we can turn our attention to the engine performance. AMG began their journey way back in the 60s, improving Mercedes' performance mechanically. They then started to turn their attention to things like styling and aerodynamics, offering a very simple front spoiler just to reduce lift. That then evolved into things like side skirts and then rear aprons and, of course, ultimately, the rear spoiler on the boot. What we have in front of us is perhaps their most radical version. It's the C126 wide body kit. It's a whole load of fiberglass parts, including replacement front wings and these rear quarter flares. Now, the whole point of the flared arches means you can actually fit much wider wheels. And of course, that almost doubles the tire contact patch, which means you improve not only the styling, the aerodynamics, but also the handling. People say nothing ventured, nothing gained, and other people are going to say this is sacrilege. This is a $2,500 car I'm cutting into. When it was AMG doing this, they were slicing into a $135,000 vehicle. Slightly more stressful, I'd imagine. Well, I've now removed both the outer skin and the inner skin as well, so I now need to put back some structural integrity. What I'm going to do is end up with a strip of metal. I'll roll it to make sure it's the right kind of arc shape, if you like. But it's actually going to come from the inner wing in there. I'll weld it in place all the way to the out and join about here. So I've chosen 16-gauge sheet metal steel for our inner fender weld, using a metal shear for the cleanest cut, and then rolling to gradually give me the arc I need. Then I trim off the edge to give me a taper before drilling the plug holes I need for the welding process. So this is my rolled piece of steel. You can see all the holes down one side. That's so I can plug weld it to the Mercedes. Now I need to attach it to the car. I'm going to use these rather clever little things called clecos. They're rather like reusable pot rivets. Just pop it into this little pair of pliers here. And then you can see, if you look at the tip, actually, as I crush it, it gets narrower. And of course, that means I can get it through a hole. And then when I release, then those little jaws open up. And of course, that holds everything in place. It's rather clever. Right, so all the welding is now complete, so finally our car has now got back its structural integrity. So the next thing I can do is actually have a go at fitting. I just hold it roughly in position, make sure we've got the filler cap in the right place. You can see there's a bit of a gap there, and that's because our little metal wing there needs to be trimmed just a little bit more. I'll take it easy until it fits perfectly. Well, that is great, because now all the hard work is done. All I have to do is prepare the metal, and then I can bond this panel in position.
Click here to subscribe.